Well, the National Space Council was reinstituted in part to reflect the leadership priorities of President Trump, and he picked Vice President Pence to chair it and to lead it because of a strong desire to see America moving again, exploring again, and being a world leader again in space. Well, in many ways, the national space policy is a form of continuity, that it continues efforts that have been underway for a long time. What the new policy directive does is it places a greater emphasis on the moon as the next step beyond low Earth orbit. Mars remains an inspiring horizon goal, but the next steps beyond Earth orbit are going to be done with commercial and international partners, and therefore we need to have a program that's feasible for them to participate in, one that offers commercial and economic advantages, and ones that can have many of our international partners participate in as we move beyond the International Space Station. The difference is today is that there have been a greater globalization of space, a greater economic growth of space, such that there's a wide number of people who are participating now who didn't before. We have many more countries who are operating in space. We have many more companies that are operating in space. So the range of innovative ideas is not coming just from the space agencies, but is really coming from our industries and from international partners. So today is very different than the past simply because of the greater number of people who are interested in working and living and developing space. Today, we need to train a new generation of explorers to be able to operate in deep space. And that in moving beyond low Earth orbit, we need to do it with commercial and international partners. This is very different than what happened in previous major space efforts, where it was really just governments and government space agencies that were leading this. This is really now a new partnership that we want the United States to lead in. We want U.S. industry to be leading, and we want to do it with our international partners who've been such great partners on Space Station, but now we want to expand and include more countries in that effort. And the moon is the next feasible step. Mars remains an inspiring horizon goal that we need to be working toward, but we first need to walk out of the neighborhood before we can run out of the neighborhood. And we need to do it in a way that reflects the world today, which is many more countries and companies that are involved in space and interested in space. And the moon remains the logical next step in order for us to bring that whole community along with us and not just go by ourselves.